a jugger. Drink the water. Don't pour it on your...
Cell tower?
Bleach.
Saying the three digits.
178.
How far is it?
500
meters. So what's our time?
15 minutes. That's good. You ready?
That tire, I think. Is what we're
gonna do. That tire?
Ready, sorry.
You work on this with your Swiss?
Yeah.
One minute.
Already established heat sources. An already established heat source could then use a metal match, right? These devices need to be held close to.
You see it, Baden?
Yeah, you can see them.
Are you ready? It's on you.
I'm
7 foot? Not 7 foot. He told me 4 foot to 7 foot.
Every time I mention it, he always.
So they're gonna come get us before that happens.
We got some more bows down here. We need them.
This is the step where I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna just double check. Maybe an area is too thin where I started here. Kind of getting a little too thin. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Fixing them. Okay, but that's a pretty good bushy amount. What I would do is just come back the opposite way with something a little thicker and push.
Right, flip that upside down.
Okay. So the reason I want it upside down is because it didn't naturally bend that way. Okay, if I put it up here,
it's gonna arc up.
It's gonna arc up. And it's gonna create a mess.
Show them, put it.
Just stick that. Missing a big one. What do rocks do in Texas? They get hot. Why would heat be a big thing for me?
Now I've got wind movement, and it's also elevated captain status. But it's all dependent on,
make sure that it's all still inside of that line, and that we don't have any overflow. That from down there, and bring it all untied. This line is going on that path.
We're good to go. That's just like my guideline for my angle. So I look at it.
Toe. 18 feet down stake, 3 across stake, and then what do I need to do with that last line?
Green and lush, okay? Why are we looking for it to be nice and green?
So one is however many feet?
Yes.
One green.
Tested it last night. Grease. Add a bit of that charcoal. Get in there, get it clean.
Sharp. Get rid of that rust. Where's your crusty rail? Just now?
What's that?
time? 24, 29.
Barn's already light.
Okay.
Open barns.
Let's go get in on there, Mr. Salazar.
Barns for time.
26:53. 26:54.
Moving in the fire, yes.
Get your gloves on.
Alexander
is ready
to lag. Also the terrain with trees, mountains, actual shelter would be a cave, something that is naturally there, maybe even
a hide and seek where we're running around in the alley or in the bushes on the playground chasing each other.
Perfect evasion, but it is, he still made it, he still managed to make it. It's the skill, and we will have to evade much like Chris Ryan did. So today I will be prepared for the worst case. Benjamin Franklin said, if we fail to prepare, we are vulnerable. You also need to know what type of environment you're going to be in. So that could be snow, you're in the Arctic. Bounds, so you can't just go out and expect to rough 100. You have to just take your time, look around, and make sure everything's okay. The radio, that compass, you can get to those rendezvous points. You can get to those drop points where you can get picked up, and that's essential.
Was set up. And then Urimo, you did the same thing you did with the kid, the 17-year-old. Man, your room is not much pacing or clicking of the finger or the IG. Squeak by at 7:05 or 7:10. But it is a passing lesson. Put your stakes back in here. I know some of you still have stakes in the ground, and that's unsat. So you're all going to start from sideways. Your shelter's not going to be able to get pulled as tight. So make sure it's directly across. Once I secure that parachute, so when you put that slip knot in, grab it tight. I grab it with your hand like this, with a reverse grip. And every single thing, go from the start, ridge line, not 180. Go double check everything. You should have grabbed everything for shelter. Time starts now.
Take everything with you, must go.